We're here with Dave Bangs, and we're talking about the development or proposed development at Whitehawk Hill. Yeah. Tell us all about it, Dave, and also about that area, because not everyone will be familiar with Whitehawk Hill, will
they? Indeed. Well, the Whitehawk Hill is part of the racecourse landscape, with the big grandstand there and the racecourse bending round right up the top of the hill along Warren Road Ridge between Woodingdean and Bear Road, and then coming down right the way down on the other side by Sheetcock Valley. It's a whole landscape in its own right.
Yep.
And the core of that landscape is the Whitehawk Hill Local Nature Reserve, and sitting pretty much on top of that local nature reserve, or at least the local nature reserve sits on top of the fact that this is actually an ancient common as well, an ancient record. It's actually been, Whitehawk Hill, this is truly astonishing, it's actually been a public downland since way back into Saxon times, since way back before the Norman Conquest. It's been in the public domain, it's been either in public ownership or with public rights over it for, well, way over a millennium. Which carries laces, right? Hey, yeah. Well, there you go, I've learned something, yeah.
So, but people want, so the council, that there was this proposal for, was it Hyde Housing, that they wanted some housing development on it?
It predates all that. I'll explain about that, but it predates that. There's a whole thing going on in the background, cooking in the background in the council, which is the creating the latest version of the city plan. Every local authority has a city plan, which has to be written off by the central government inspectors and that. And Brighton Council for a whole number of years has been putting together the latest version of this. And in this latest version of the city plan, they've actually fingered Whitehawk Hill for three housing development sites. One slap bang in the middle at the kind of wasp waste, the narrowest point of Whitehawk Hill, where it bends down in a great horseshoe at the north end, a big site there. And then two more sites on the highest ground in that racecourse landscape, up on the top of Race Hill, near the mast you're talking about there. One site there and one site up towards Woodingdean there. So they've actually fingered that landscape for three development sites, and two of those development sites just sit out there in open downland completely on their own. They're on old smallholding farmsteads.
Dave, we're going to leave it there for now, but you'll keep us posted, no doubt. Thanks.